when I get set on bottom, and this top leg is on, I'm just straight away on the whistle, just trying to get there as fast as I can, all right? Speed of lightning, whammy, all right? Things are gonna happen. This guy's, if he's any good on top, he's probably gonna get to his favorite hold. Maybe 50% of the time he'll get to his favorite hold, whatever. I guess we can counter kind of what we did earlier. We were doing a power half this morning. So go ahead and get a power half. All right, so this isn't that fun. I don't want to get cranked on. One thing that I like when guys when I'm on top, when I'm doing the power half, I like when guys grab this foot. So go ahead and power half me. Yep. When guys start reaching down and grabbing this foot, they kind of lost their post and they're getting cranked right to the back. So I would not really advocate, even in the sit-up position, really reaching down and grabbing his foot. If he's any good, he's going to take it right to my back. And even though you're wrenching on his foot, it might not feel great on him, right? He's getting back points, so it's kind of defeats the purpose. So what I do is I don't really attack his hands either. Some guys swim. That's pretty good. I like to swim. I like to attack his feet. So if he's up here power halfing, right? I learned a foot fight. And what that looks like is just, it's not really that technical. I'm just kind of pushing his feet down so I can windshield wiper, kind of using these feet as windshield wipers, and I straighten my leg so I can get my knee in front of his leg right here, and his leg's out. So go ahead and get that power half again. So here, it's kind of really not that technical. I'm just kind of doing this with my feet so I can push his foot down and straighten my leg out. As soon as I straighten my leg out, his leg comes out, and I get my knee back in front. If he holds on to that power half, right, he doesn't really have anything now. He's just kind of floating. I'm going to get a reversal pretty easily. So just learning to foot fight without a partner, it looks like this. Kind of just doing this constantly. And then when I'm ready, I just kind of kick that out. So like a donkey will kick, right? That's kind of what I'm doing. Using these as windshield wipers. And then I kick when I'm ready to get that leg out. I don't let it back in. Bring my knee to my chest so I can't get that leg back in. Just kind of clearing what we did earlier today. Learning the counter. I think that's important. So he gets a power half, right? Using my feet, and I just straighten my leg out. See, it didn't even take that much. Say he has a lock. Go ahead and lock your feet. Alright, I'm gonna have to kick it off so that I can get his foot down. See how I straighten my leg. Legs in, straighten it. Keep your knee in front, now I'm out. Okay, if he holds on to the power half, you're getting a reversal. Usually he won't, then I get right back to his fingers. Squeeze those things, stand up, get away. Always looking to grab his fingers when I can, get him away from you. So one more time, then we'll go do it, pretty easy. Top guy, get a power half, all right? And just learn how to foot fight. Just constantly kick his feet out, right? I'm gonna straighten my leg when I'm ready. I like to kind of push his foot down too, so I'll put weight on his foot with my leg so I can straighten, get my knee in front. Get his fingers if he lets go. Okay? Here, stand up, get away. Pretty easy. Any questions there, guys? Yeah. Okay, go do it, go.